So our second race from Musselburgh is the Edinburgh Mill Handicap Hurdle over 2 miles and a furlong. So we wait for the runners. It's a 0-90, so it should be a small field. So number one is Seductress for Paul Rhodes, two is Signatory Oakley for Thomas Rogers, three is Manitoba for Stu Gray, and four is Sapphire and Steel for Martin Leedham. Just the four, they'll all get a bit of prize money here if they all get round. Flags dropped and they're away. And it is Seductress. It's going to lead us to the first. And Paul looking at a quick fire double. He's hurdle handicapped here in Musselburgh. Follow up his win in the last. Carlita Negra. Seductress, the top weight in this race. He's gone 5-6 lengths in front from Sapphire and still in second. Manitoba's just behind him. And then the grey Signatory Oki make up the four. So as they get to the first, it's going to be Seductress, 6 length advantage, hits it slowly, steady, over it well, Sapphire and still in second on his own, and a couple back to Signatory Oki and Manitoba. Our leader is Seductress, taking a little bit of a hold now, running a little bit freely up front, gets to the second, takes that one better. Bit of a mistake towards the rear, Signatory Oki just brushed the top of it, lost a bit of a momentum. Mine's a single file, more or less. It's probably 15 lengths between first and last. So the leader goes over the third. Come up the grandstand. Doesn't look like much of a hill here at Musselburgh. There it is, as you can see. So it is Seductress that leads by about 5 to Sapphire and Steel. About 3 back to Manitoba. So length and a half to Signatory Oki, the grey. So as we go out for another complete circuit, Seductress still running freely, still being held onto by his jockey. Doesn't seem to want to settle in front. Still got a 5 length advantage from Sapphire and Steel. There's a couple back to Manitoba. Further 2 to Signatory Oki. So Seductress pretty much reached the halfway point. Being held steady up to take that hurdle there, the lead up. So we come down to a mile from home. Is Seductress still by 4 to Sapphire and still Manitoba, Signatory Oki. Finally, the leader takes it well. Seems to have settled better now, but Seductress still leads us by about 5. Sapphire and still, as we were, Manitoba in third, being pushed along now to try and get closer. We'll skip over the 6. So it was 4 from home, which is 3 to take, so it's Seductress still leads. A couple of lengths now from Sapphire and Steel. It's getting a bit closer. And still a couple back to Manitoba. Same with Signatory Oki. Since we come down to 5 furlongs and swing right-handed, it's Seductress that still leads. His lead's down to about 4 now. Sapphire and Steel have made up a little bit. And a couple of lengths back to Manitoba. Signatory Oki's even further back now. So as we come down to the final half, it's 4 furlongs to go. And it's Seductress. Asks for everything now and starts to go, being run down hopefully by Sapphire and Steel to make this a bit of a battle as they go over the 7th. Manitoba still running on, but way out of it. Signatory Oki's never going to win, but it's Seductress now being closed down by Sapphire and Steel as we come down to 2.5 furlongs from home. And it's Seductress from Sapphire and Steel. Manitoba's still there. They both go over the penultimate well. So Seductress, Sapphire and Steel on his outside. Seductress giving weight away here to Sapphire and Steel. Still got 1.5 furlongs to run, 1 to jump. And it's Seductress and Sapphire and Steel. They go over it together. They land together. And it's Sapphire and Steel that just noses in front from Seductress on the inside. Sapphire and Steel, Seductress. These two are neck and neck. Coming back into it is Seductress from Sapphire and Steel. Sapphire and Steel fights back yet again, and it's Sapphire and Steel by a nose, but it's Seductress going to go, and it's Sapphire and Steel just by a nose, I think, from Seductress. Manitoba will run on for third, and then Signatory Oki picks up fourth place, money for Tom Rogers. So, just on a head bob, and it's gone to Martin Leedham. He will be pleased. And it is just by a bob to Seductress of Paul Rhodes in second. Third was Manitoba for Stu Great. And as I said, Thomas Rogers, Signatory Oki was fourth. So, yeah, there was a 1.5 stone almost in it there. It's no surprise Sapphire and Steel just managed to short-head it. Let's go to our final race here at Musselburgh.